Hey guys, in this video we will make concept map of red blood cells, also called erythrocytes. So let's start. Red blood cells are biconcave discs. Its diameter is about 8 micron and thickness is 2 micron at periphery and 1 micron at the center. Now this shape offers some advantages to the RBC. For example, it makes the cell thin, so gases can rapidly move in and out from even the innermost region of the cell. Second, it can squeeze through narrow capillaries easily without getting damaged. Also, it provides larger surface area for exchange of gases. Normal red blood cell count is about 4 to 5.5 million per cubic millimeter. Now, RBCs have hemoglobin which carry out transport of oxygen and transport of carbon dioxide. It also acts as buffer and contribute in acid-base balance. RBCs have limited enzymes. It includes carbonic anhydrase, which carry out conversion of carbon dioxide into bicarbonate. This conversion is required for transport of carbon dioxide. Other enzymes are glycolytic enzymes, which carry out glycolysis. Now let's talk about production and lifespan of RBC. RBCs are produced by erythropoiesis at bone marrow. Lifespan of RBC is about 120 days. During this period, membrane of RBC eventually becomes fragile. So RBCs undergo destruction which occurs at the spleen. RBCs lack organelles which frees up space in RBC to carry more hemoglobin. This helps RBC in carrying out its function of transporting gases more efficiently. However, this advantage comes with some disadvantages. For example, lack of mitochondria means no contribution of mitochondria in ATP production. So glycolysis is the only source of ATP in RBC. Also, RBCs lack nucleus, so there is no DNA or RNA. So they cannot synthesize proteins for repair and neither can replenish enzymes. This is the reason for short lifespan of only 120 days for RBC as compared to other cells of the body which have much longer life. Finally, RBCs do not have insulin receptors, so glucose uptake by RBC is independent of insulin. That's it friends. This is our short and sweet concept map of red blood cells. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.